Thanks, everybody. Welcome to my talk, Building Nice Command Line Interfaces, a look beyond the standard library. I am Patrick Mühlbauer. I'm a backend developer at Blue Yonder. I'm working in Karlsruhe. And this is my third EuroPython now, but the first time as a speaker. I'm pretty excited being able to speak here today. And what I want to talk about are command line interfaces, and I want to show you a little demo in the beginning. I wrote today. It's called Brewery. I thought I'm originally from Bavaria. I thought German guy from Bavaria, I'd do something with beer. So this is a typical help screen. I think everyone here knows what a command line interface and such a help screen is. So you see a usage line. You have a little description. You see you have some options and, of course, some subcommands. And yeah, you can call these subcommands. You have separated help pages for your subcommands. This would look like this. So here we have a list command. We can, here we can see we are able to list some of the beers. So this would like this. Okay. Yeah, and these are actual beers from the Augustiner Brewery, a famous brewery from Munich. And we can also list, we have some other options. We can list our own beers. We don't have any by now, but we can buy us a beer. So this, so let's look what the buy command looks like. So we have an option name and an option count. So let's use this. Let's buy a six pack of beer. So now we have six bottles of pills. Yeah. So that's just as a short introduction, so you get the idea what a command line interface is if you don't know already. And what I want to talk about is, if you are new to Python or programming, you might wonder how to start. So as I started programming, I ended up parsing sys.argv by hand, and I have seen others doing the same. So sys.argv is just a list of the command line arguments, and if you try to parse that by yourself, you end up with pretty ugly code. Or you start writing your own parser, but yeah, there are already some like getopt. GetOpt is an implementation. It's the implementation for Python, but it's actually from C. And if you are familiar with the C programming language and have used GetOpt, it might be a good fit for you. But I don't recommend to use it. It's not really nice. So if you want to stick to the standard library, you might find OptParse or ArcParse more pleasant. I have to say, OptParse is deprecated by now. ArcParse is the newer one, and yeah, ArcParse, I think it's okay. It does its job. It's pretty straightforward. But if your application grows and you have multiple subcommands, you always have to create all these subparsers, and yeah, the code starts growing not that nice. So if you think so too, you might be wondering if there's more. And yeah, there is. So I want to show you today three libraries which are out there, Click, DocOpt, and Cliff. The first one is Click. It's a project created by Armin Ronacher. I think a lot of you know him. He's quite popular in the Python community. He has created, for example, Flask and Jinja. And he was also not that happy with the solutions already out there. So he decided to write his own, and Click was born. Click is a decorator implementation, so you use decorators to mark your functions as commands, for example. And click is highly configurable, and it also comes with good defaults. So DocOpt has a completely different approach. For DocOpt, you have seen this help screens. For DocOpt, you just write these help screens, and then you already have your parser. DocOpt will pass this doc string, and then you get your arguments as a dictionary. So the third one is Cliff. It's from a developer from OpenStack. And Cliff is more like a framework for multi-level commands, something like Git, for example, where you have this Git add, Git push, and so on. And for its subcommands, it uses setup tools entry points. So you define an entry point in your setup Py, and then Cliff will find it, and yeah, I will show you that later on. And it also comes with output formatters. I have a little demo. It's better I show you that later. So let's start with Click. How does it look like? A minimal example would look like this. You just have a function and decorate it with the command decorator, and yeah, you're done. Then you could call your script, and you already would get a help message looking like that, which is the starting point for DocOpt. So in DocOpt, you start writing this help message, then use the DocOpt function, put the doc string in it, and get back the dictionary of the passed arguments and options. So for Cliff, this is a little bit more code. But actually, it's not that complicated. There are two important things here. It's this app class and the command manager. So you have the subclass from app, and then you can, and you have to pass a command manager to it. And this command manager is, yeah, the command manager says how subcommands should be found. And the default command manager here finds subcommands via setup tool entry points, like I already said. So it looks for setup entry points in the Cliff brewery, cliff.brewery entry point names. So subcommands. For Click, you have another decorator called group. So now you say your run function should be a group, and then you use this group to decorate other functions as commands, as subcommands, which belong then to this group. It's just these two lines of code, and you have your first subcommand. So in DocOpt, it's a bit more complicated. If you want to have separate help messages for each subcommand, because you could, what you could do using subcommands is just write multiple usage lines where you can say instead of command you have list, by, and so on. But then you would not have separate help messages. So what you can do is you can implement your subcommand in another module, write your doc string there, and then so check here if the command you used is, for example, list, import the module, and then put its doc string to DocOpt. Well, as using DocOpt with subcommands is not really nice, like you can see probably. So, and now Cliff, here in your setup Py, you have this entry points, keywords argument, and now you say, again, this cliff.brewery entry point group, and to define a subcommand, you say, for example, list equals brewery.commands, which is the brewery package in then the commands module. And in the commands module is a class called beerListCommand, which would look something like this. So you just subclass from CliffCommand. And then you would have to overload the takeAction function. The takeAction function already gets depassed arguments as arguments, and these are an argpass namespace object. So Cliff uses argpass internally. So next. Yeah, if you want to use, you probably want to use options and arguments. So in Click, it's again just a decorator. You have an option decorator. So here we say we want to add a debug option to our run group. And we also say it should be a flag. So it's just a Boolean value in the end. And the same for arguments. You have an extra argument decorator. Here we say we want a filter argument, and this is then also passed to the list function. So in docopt, again, it's just writing your options and arguments in the doc string. So for example, here, if you have a subcommand list, which gets this optional filter argument, optional in such a help message are these brackets. And here's also an example how such a dictionary would look like, what you get from the docopt function. So again, in Cliff, you would have to overload the get parser method. There you always have to retrieve the parser, which is an argparse argument parser. And then just use the add argument method to add the filter argument. So here the in get parser, it's just argparse. Okay, another feature perhaps you don't only want optional arguments, perhaps you want repeating arguments. In Click, you could achieve this with the keyword argument nArgs in the argument decorator. So if you use -1, for example, this means you can put an infinite number of filter arguments to your command. And filter would then be a tuple of strings, not just a string. In docopt, again, just documenting it. So in such a help screen, repeating are these ellipses, these 3 points. And the filter in the args dictionary would be a list. Argparse has also an nArgs keyword argument, but here it's not a -1, it's an asterisk. And yeah, that's all. So another thing are defaults. So you don't want to specify a value to every option all the time. So for example, for our buy command, we could say, if we don't specify a number of bottles we want to buy, then just buy one. So this is done in Click by the default keyword argument. And you also have a required argument if you really want to say this option should be given as specified. In docopt, you have to add this default one to the end of the option help string, and same for required. And yeah, that's all basically. Okay. For ArcPass, again, it's the same like for click, just the required and default argument, keyword argument. One difference here is that click uses, if you specify a default value, click uses the type of the value as default, type. So if you would use count with something else than an integer, you would get, click would raise an error. And so what you probably also want is type support to validate your arguments and options. Also in click you have a type keyword argument, and click also has nice utilities, for example custom types. Here I used an int range as type because buying zero or less bottles would be nonsense anyway, so I said it should be between one and infinity. DocOpt does not have any types, it's everything is a string or a bool, and you have to do the checking all by yourself. For ArcPass, you also have this type keyword argument, it's working basically the same, like in click. Okay, so another feature, if you want to automate things, for example, you might want to use environment variables, and in click, again, it's just another keyword argument, so you specify an env var, and in the example you can see if you don't have this env var set already, the default value would be used, but if you set this env var, then the env var is used. DocOpt, again, does not have support for environment variables, and also ArcPass does not have built-in support, but you can do this little trick. So you just set a default value and use the environment dictionary. And yeah, then you have basically the same effect like in click. So you probably also want to test your stuff if it's, and in click, this is really nice because click comes with a with an extra testing module, and in this testing module you have a key runner, and if you with this key runner you can just invoke your commands, and then you get back a result object, and this result object then holds the exit code and the output. So testing what a command returns is really easy. Using other stuff like ArcPass and so on, I don't have a really good pattern. So if you have one, I would be glad if you come to me. It's what you find in the internet is always the same. You just call your function and then, or probably some people use the subprocess module to call just your script and then pass the output and so on, but that just does not seem right. So what I did here is I used PyTest for testing, and PyTest has this capsis fixture, and if you use this fixture it captures the output, and then you can test at the output in a similar way than to this click solution. Okay, so one last thing for Cliff. Cliff has, I already mentioned these output formatters, and Cliff has special subcommands. For example, this lister is just a subclass from command, and I probably show you, it's best I show you this. So here's Cliff implementation. You also have a list command, and
if you use this Lister class I showed you, then you would get this ugly output. So it's a table. It's really awful, okay, but you have this extra option which comes with Cliff. You can say you want it to be 40. Yeah. It's okay, the resolution is not really nice here, but you can see you get a nice table just by doing nothing by yourself, basically. What you have to do is you have to structure the data you want to show in this table. So it's just one header row and then multiple rows you want to show, and then, yeah, that's all. So, one other thing, Cliff is pretty cool when using plugins. So here we can see we don't have a drink command, which is really sad. So we can just go, well, think of this brewery drink like a plugin, and here we have this entry point defined. So we have here drink command in this plugin, and if we install it now, then yeah, now we have a drink command. Nice. So yeah, and as a summary, my favorite is Qlik. It's really nice working with Qlik. You have a lot of utilities. It's very robust. It's just fun to work with. DocOpt is nice if you are already familiar with these help messages and you really want to write nice documentation and so on. But for, I think for bigger applications, it's not that good. And yeah, Cliff, I really like these output formatters in Cliff. It's really easy to get a nice table, or what I, what I have not shown you is you already, you also have multiple formatters. For example, you can say you want the output as CSV, or there are also extensions to get JSON or YAML. And you can also specify the columns you want to show. So if you just want the beer names and the descriptions, then yeah, you would just have two columns. So, and I think we are out of time, and that's the end. So thanks for your attention. If you have questions, just ask, or ask at the coffee. Yeah.
Well, thanks for your talk. One common usage in options is to have the long option with hyphen hyphen name and the short one with maybe hyphen N. Mm-hmm. I don't recall seeing any particular examples about that, but I assume all of these tools would support that easily.
So what you mean is you want to have something like this and this?
And yeah, sure. Okay. You could use either one the same thing.
But you can do that in all three solutions. So.
Okay, great, thanks.
More questions?
Hi. I'm just curious, have you seen the Google's flags parsing library? I think it's called Python gflags. And if you've seen, what's your opinion about it?
No.
Okay.
Easy.
Do they have support for colors in the output?
Sorry, I...
Do they have support for colors in the output?
Support for what?
Color.
Yeah. For color, oh yeah. So I click has this echo function. I used it on one of my slides, I think. It's basically something, it's something like the print function, but it has a lot of stuff internally to handle Unicode for you on different platforms and so on. And it also has a keyword argument for colors. And yeah, then you would get colors. I think in DocOpt and Cliff or ArcPass, you don't have this built in. So, yeah.
I would like a tool that reads all these complex definitions from a configuration file and not do them in the code inline. Which is the best one to do that? Or maybe it's not an option at
okay.
all.
Okay. You mean for DocOpt or what?
For each of these tools, I don't want to write long lines of code. I want to be able to add a function, go to a YAML file, and add a new command, and be done with it.
Sorry, I don't know if it might be possible somehow, but I don't okay. know.
But more questions?
Thanks for the talk. Do you have any good solutions for interactive command line interface?
Interactive. Well, Cliff has interactive built in, I think. Do you mean something like that? Or? But that's the only thing I know. I don't know if there's something else or for Click or. Sorry.
Yeah, so I actually have an answer to that. So we use Click and Cookie Cutter for the prompting and the user interface. So Click is actually capable of doing very, very great interactive command line prompts.
Oh, okay.
So it should be just Click Prompt, and then you have different options, so you can do choices and such. So.
Yeah.
Yeah, tomorrow at 11:45, my talk, I will talk about this as well.
Yeah, so yeah. I think I got the question wrong, but you have this prompt, a click dot prompt, and then you get just prompted for an option, or is it that what you mean? Yes, yeah, a click has it.
More questions? I do have one last one then. In your last projects, which one of these tools did you use?
I personally use most of the time Click.
Okay.
But Cliff is actually quite new to me, too. But I really like these output format stuffs. So if I have a project where I could need this, just creating CSV file out of some other data or so, then I think it's a really good fit.
Okay. And I think we're out of time for any more questions anyway, so we will let you go to the coffee break. And thank you again, Patrick.